Arcs of energy jump over the surface of the device for a few moments, then cease. The cavern becomes eerily quiet. Huh. Oh, crap. Codex entry unlocked, Crystalvore. Use the machinery to find a way to protect yourself from the Crystalvores. Okay. I would love to turn it back on, but I can't. I can activate this, supposedly.
Absolutely.
Even though this enormous machine is silent now, you can see faint lights deep within, pulsing like slow heartbeats of or distant stars. From a brief glance at the infrastructure inside the machine, you deduced it was designed to keep the Crystalvores docile. I can't turn this back on, right? I can't. I can't even select it. I can't even examine it.
Fair enough.
85% digging through machine for useful parts. Success. Ooh, critical success. Behind a sealed panel, you find a small emitter linked to a powerful signal routing device. You should be able to use it to surround yourself with the energy this machine produces. Cool. So we need to get in there. Ow. Unfortunately, they're all gonna go first, aren't they? So, harmonic repulsion repels Crystalvores within its radius. So, Eretus doesn't have it yet. I'm guessing it. Either he has to be in farther, or it takes place next round. I'd say let's start using some of these things. Cool. Sunspot icon. Valid position? I guess I just cast it near me. And it makes a cool sound. Okay. Let me get within this thing.
I'm going.
And what kind of cipher do I have to use? Changing tool now. Non-combat. Ooh. Reanimate the muscles of a humanoid corpse. Well, these are not humanoid. I actually hate to use some of these things. I'll use the barrel just in case.
Huh?
for, is it? Barrel of Indomitability. 6 points of health per turn, plus 100 damage.
Just what I needed.
Now your fettle's gone, which is a good thing. Whose turn is it? Calstige? Let me just see. Yeah, she doesn't have it yet either.
It is done.
She's a little farther in, right? Just trying to see if we have to wait. Yeah, I guess it takes place next round. Because I just ran in here just now. Either that or I really... This field is... A bit, what do you call it? Misleading, and you have to be further in. Okay. What does she have? Burning Mouse. That's the Fresh Vapors. That's 5 uses, but... Last time I used it, I'm pretty sure I never used it before, and it was gone. 25 chemical damage, I'd probably use that one. Yeah. Hypercoolant spray. Out of range. Okay, I guess I'm not using that. Okay, I'm not gonna use any of her things this time then. Right in there, though. What? Ooh! That's nice. That thing really did its job. Is it gone now? Or is that it? This thing's got 1 point. It's got 4 points. Which one has 1 point? Oh, this one? Well, still. He has a lot more might than strength, so I'm just gonna have him just outright attack here.
No hard feelings.
Meh. This is cool though. I like the way those things walk. It's so crazy.
Disgusting. I should be rid of this.
Heard that. Critical hit, right? I think I chose that. Now every time he hits, he gains +3 damage, and then +3, +3, something like that. I chose him. Crescendo? +3 damage to his attacks for the rest of the crisis. Oh, it stacks with each critical hit. So if he critical hits again, it'll plus six damage to his attacks for the rest of the crisis and so on. That's sweet, though. Who gets to go? Me? What do I have? Did I already look? I already looked, didn't I? I have a healing thing, I think. Should I use it on Aretas? It might be, actually. one of these. Heals 2 to 6 points of health per turn. Target is... self? Or... the bearer. Target is self. Should just say that. But... that's cool. I could use healing too. I'm looking to heal somebody else though. I'm pretty much okay. I could use one of these spray flashes, but... let me see if I have anything else. Yeah, I think it's something else. I could control something. I could summon a Balefire. Yeah, why not? Yeah, Balefire. Choose position right next to this damn thing. Sweet. Balefire. Okay, so still on me. I'm fine where I am. This thing, I guess, is dead. So we've got what else? We've got just two more. Oh yeah, you can see them up here. I'm thinking there might be others who haven't joined the fight though yet, and that if we move in one direction, actually further into the chamber this way, there'll be more of them. So I'm gonna end my turn. Oh, she's bleeding? What? That's no good. Active until when? Active 6 rounds. We can remove that fettle if you want to. Just wait on that, actually. Maelstrom? Ah, too bad these guys are separated. It's an area attack. It's not going to be that useful. But maybe I'll just use it. For intellect. I'm gonna save her intellect, actually. I suspect there's gonna be another battle, possibly, when we leave this area. This is only 2 intellect. 1. This thing is full. 8 physical damage. It's already hobbled, isn't it? I think so. Actually, I hope it doesn't hit the Balefire. Excellent. Ah, missed. Well, that sunspot icon is pretty cool. Yay! Destroy our enemies. Hook, line, and sinker. Draw him into where he's got that fettle. Oh, it didn't work because the Balefire is in the way. Damage. Passed him. Maybe he can use it? He's coming from the side. Out of range. He can run all the way over here, though.
the very soul of action.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you are, my friend. Sucker punch.
I bet your ancestors felt that.
Hehe. It's ancestors. Cool. Oh, they're exploding. Away from that thing.
Something to do.
Shard explosion.
I'm ready.
See, now we can interact with it. Alright, anything... Do these things leave any, like... No.
Of course.
Watch, there's more. Oh, it's following us. That's cool. Okay, so we got some loot. And we got that thing. I bet you it's in there.
Without doubt.
I can't... select it.
I'm going.
20 shins? A devouring shell. Safer. Confers shell arm. Wow. Plus 20 armor. Whoa. That's freaking awesome.
These ciphers are killing me.
Oh god, we got rid of one. You're okay. Active for 5 rounds. This smooth oval dome resembles a large egg sliced lengthwise. Its silky but unyielding surface is marred by an irregular crack running most of its length, into which have been wedged many tiny crystalline rods. It emits a faint, sickly sweet odor, and a slight shimmer envelops the rods, like the air over a fire. A very fitting place to have something like this. The underside looks and feels fuzzy, though it's seemingly formed from the same substance as the hard shell. It clings to your touch, it clings to your touch, and when you pull away, you notice a drop of blood on your fingertip. You suspect it might be unwise to stay in contact with the object for too long. Indeed. Plus 20. I'll have this on me. I'll use this when I go into, you know, my labyrinth to fight the sorrow. Or I could use it against the changing god. I suspect that the changing god, though... I mean, no spoilers, please. Because by the time you reach this, well, I may or may not have gotten to the end. I don't know. But in any case, I suspect that the changing god might be like the transcendent one, because they're basically following a lot of what Planescape Torment did, and that the transcendent one could be reasoned out of fighting. You can actually reason him out of existence. So, possibly the same. Or similar.
I'm ready.
Now I can get to this good. 28 shins, and another cipher. Hero's Fury. Oh, I remember Hero from the Necropolis area.
I'm carrying too many ciphers.
Yes, I know. We're gonna change them out. Deals 36 energy damage and confers Dazed. Hero's Fury, which is minus 15% willpower, and on attacks, 10 energy damage per turn. Active entire crisis. This thin, short length of bright silken string is innocuous. But when rubbed between the hands, it starts generating its own heat and energy, eventually uncoiling into a whip of dark, red, crackling energy. When it strikes an enemy, it tightly constricts itself around the target. Seems like a good thing for Callisthenes to have. Alright. The only thing left is to mess with this thing.
On it.
So mess with it we shall. Interesting how it's centered on us, this wave, and not the crystalline... the two crystalline things. Nestled among the crystal formations is a steel pod. Cables pass in and out of the pod, glowing with energy. As soon as you're within arm's reach, a shining interface materializes in the air between you and the pod. There are a few strange symbols arranged in a circle around a filigreed pentagon similar to the tattoo on your head. Oh, this is where this comes into place, the three geodesics to the barycenter. Place your hand on the pentagon. Nothing happens. Touch your own tattoo to the center symbol. Ooh. Got it! I didn't have to enter any code. Huh. As you draw closer, the filigreed pentagon grows more brightly. Glows, actually. Your head becomes warm, but not uncomfortably so. When it touches the light, you feel a small amount of energy flow out from you. The cables on the pod pulse quickly, and the top of the chamber opens with a hiss. The only item inside is a hyaline circlet, as black as the sky behind the stars. The magmatic annulet. You remove it from the pod and take it with you. This crystalline circlet is as black as the sky behind the stars. It twists and curls in eye-bending patterns, emanating power as if absorbing and staring the realities of the world. Cool. So what the hell does this thing do anyway?
Making a note.
The chamber hisses shut and the interface vanishes. Now that I have the annulet, I can bring it to Dracogen and complete my side of the bargain. I discovered that Dracogen once attempted to steal an item called the Navigational Cortex from the anchorage of the Lascars. Perhaps he would be willing to accept the cortex in place of the annulet. Oh, really? I'm kind of unclear on that, if he wanted both things or just one. I think he just wanted the one thing when he found out... when he got to the other place that he wanted the other thing. But I think it was...
All right.
Now that it's empty, the pod has sealed itself shut. The shining interface no longer appears when you're nearby. Alright, time to leave.
In this world, then.
Let's see what kind of surprises await us. Well, we have this hum around us. Oh, this Crystalvore is there, too. Oh, damn it. Blocking our way. I had a feeling. I think we saw them.
I'm always ready.
What if I just turn this whole thing back on? The image is dimmed, showing no power flowing into it. Device powers up again. Unsurprisingly, the Phobit doesn't return. Oh, so that was for that. Well, that's fine that we turn that back on. The parallel lines is for the resonance chamber. Circular glyph. An image appears depicting the humming device in the center of the room, the one with two crystals. It flashes angrily. Red parallel lines cut through the lines of power. The circular symbol is gone. There seems to be no way to restore power to the broken device. Unless we return this thing, we can't. The device stands silent, bereft of power. It smells of burned synth, suggesting that it's been seriously damaged and may not be repairable. Yeah, we can't do anything with that. Alright, let's fight our way out of here. There probably was a way to get in here without turning that off and then taking the stuff out of there. But machine once again vibrates with energy. Yeah, they're still there.
Why not?
I have to fight these friggin' things. Just wanna leave, you know? Let me guess, it's out of range for the hook. Maybe not. And now, we can also attack it.
Barely making a scratch.
That's not good. Look at that thing. It's got little pinchers. It's very similar to Stika. I wonder if they either ran out of good ideas or they're going to reveal that Stika formed from these things or vice versa. It's very similar to the whole Stika thing with the sound waves having an impact on it. Next time we get a break, I should heal Aratus and maybe someone else.
My attack didn't feel strong at all. At all.
Huh, I wonder why.
What's happening to me?
It ran right out. I'm bleeding, that's what's happening. Little stinker ran out of there. I want to save the shell armor. There's a whole bunch of these coming. Yeah, they're coming from around... Oh my god, there's so many. There's no other way out of here. Escape the cavern or defeat the Crystalvores. Well, we could keep run through them, I guess. Do I get experience from them?
Natural.
All right. Good time to use up her cipher. This one. Out of range. And she can't move any further.
With alacrity.
Of course, you know it's going to attack her. Well, they're probably all going to attack her.
Probable. Sadly, effective.
I can't reach. Boom.
Barely making a scratch.
Disgusting. I should be rid of this.
Yeah. So if he hooks this one, he can't reach it. He can't reach any of them. I just attacked this one then. Saying that a lot. Are these things just very tough?
I'm ready.
Oh, that's me? Oh crap, I thought I was still on Aratus.
Just what I needed.
I wish I could heal other people. Oh, we're on Calisthenes now, so we're going to use her cipher. Finally. Choose an enemy.
Another one dispatched.
Nice. And got rid of a fettle.
Making a scratch.
Yeah, right, too.
Heroic strike of heroic proportions.
Much better.
Thank you.
It exploded and she said thank you. Well, that's me, I'll just attack it.
You dare strike me?
Uh-huh. Now, do we gain experience? Less hit points, I can tell you that much. Alright, so... I use it on... myself.
Yes.
13. Eretus.
More danger? So be it.
I heal more actually, so
yes.
I should heal everyone when out of combat. Because I get 5 extra points.
How may I go?
And then we'll switch things around. Much better. Eretus and I could still use some. Very nice.
Onward! Ah! Oh, that's much better. Just like that.
Nah. All right. Now, someone needs speed badly. Well, we're gonna save and continue. I don't think... there's no loot from these things. And it doesn't look like we're gonna experience. So I might just be here. You know what, though? If I'm gonna run out of here... hastened. Hasten me, baby. Look at our negative fettles. Fibrous bar negative.
Yes.
Hold on a second. I actually want inventory. No one has an actual open slot. You know, I'm gonna sell that one that actually clears the fog of war. I don't see a use for that. I mean, who cares? I'll just clear it myself.
To action!
I'm thinking it might be helpful for some kind of, like, maze or something. There's so many. But I could just run past them right there.
Naturally.
And I'm hastened, so I'm always the slowpoke. So just run as far as you can. My voice is all wavery again. Cute little things, if they weren't...
I feel terrible.
...so... aggressive.
To action!
To running away! Yeah, this is... kinda hurts.
Disgusting. I should be rid of this.
I'm glad we healed up. A lot of these friggin' things. Again, if I could tell they were giving me experience, I mean, maybe they are, just didn't say. Glad I'm hastened. I still only run as fast as everyone else.
Yes, now.
Or if they were giving off loot? I mean, maybe there's a rare chance of getting a valuable gem from them. I don't know. Let's just get the hell out of here. Calisthenes can really move. She can run all the way up here.
Naturally.
She can move there naturally. They're all gonna get in attacks on us. Ouch.
On my way.
Can he go through, or do we have to gather our party? We have to gather our party before venturing forth. In which case, all these things attack us some more. Hey, there was one other person who was scattered. Huh.